Hello friends, good evening and welcome to the webinar on better compliance with greater assurance. I am CA Abdul Rafiq, Managing Director of Windsor Infotech Limited. I'm delighted to welcome you to this webinar where we'll discuss how you can provide better compliance with greater assurance. These are the learning objectives. We will be primarily giving a demo of a data analytics software called SoftCat. So these are the four learning objectives. Why use SoftCat for assurance? Two, how to use SoftCat for assurance? Three, what are the key audit tests you can perform using SoftCat? Four, demo of audit tests using SoftCat. I would like to take about 10 to 15 minutes to cover the first three concepts and spend more than 30 minutes on giving you a practical demo of how to use SoftCat and the various audit features. Now, these concepts of data analytics will be useful to you even if you are using any other software or you are using even MS Excel. The primary objective of my presentation in this webinar is to demonstrate how CAs and CXOs can automate to accelerate progress. How do we automate to accelerate progress? This is a brief introduction of myself. I passed my CA final in 1985, CSA exam in 1995, and I've been passionate about using technology, and I've used technology extensively for doing all my IT-enabled services, and that's where I began developing solutions for my own use. And in 2000, I started working on developing solutions for CAs and CXOs. My primary interest is in data analytics, BI, and COBIT. I've also been a faculty for the DISA course right from the beginning. This is a vision, mission, and strategy for company. We believe in being a global leading solution provider in data analytics for empowering professionals to realize the potential by applying thought to technology. So if you look at the key word, we are looking at how CAs can apply their analytical skills to technology and harness the power of technology. Now let's get started with the subject. Why use data analytics software? Now, it said data analytics is a must-have capability for the audit function and is widely expected to become a big part of its future. Although my presentation is here focused on CAs, you'll find this can be used not only by CAs as auditors, but also for compliance. It can also be used for assurance. It can also be used for fraud investigation. Data analytics concept can also be used by management for BI. What is data analytics all about? Let's look at a very simple definition. Data analytics is defined as the science of examining raw data with the purpose of drawing conclusions about that information. Now, data analytics can be done from two perspectives. One is from the analyst perspective or the business perspective. Second is from the technology perspective. Most of the cases, data analytics is used quite often and is confused with data science. Data science is different. This is done by the technologists where you actually look at how you can harness the power of technology by building the solutions. From the perspective of business, especially from an auditor perspective or a CA perspective, we are looking at how we can use the inherent powers of the technology to derive insight from information. What can you do with data analytics or BI? This just gives you some quick examples. You can establish facts. For example, you'd like to know what are the number of invoices which have been billed during the year and what are the total value of the transactions. You can establish that fact and confirm with the GST returns filed. You can explore hunches. For example, you have a hunch that the credit card is being misutilized, the credit card facility is being misutilized, or let's say the debtor's credit period is being misused by some of the customers. You can explore this hunch by querying the data and extracting relevant information to check whether a hunch is right or is it incorrect. Next, you can draw inferences from the data. You should always remember that no software can replace the auditor. Any data analytics software can provide you information, which is processed data. But to infer insights, it requires business domain knowledge and subject matter expertise. And that's what as CAs we have. we can also confirm hindsight, which means what happened in the past. I would like to know what are the pattern of the sales which happened in the past and confirm what has happened in the current. I can also look at that. We can also obtain insights in terms of the data by making comparative analysis of the past and the current, and then we can also project into the future, which is what we call as validate foresight. So if you look at data analytics, can be done with the data of the past, of the current, and you can also make predictions of the future. Here, quite often, if you look at data analytics from a business perspective, from a CA perspective, we are looking at data of the past, which was historical data. We also look at the data which is available currently up to a particular period so that we can do analysis based on the assurance or the compliance objectives. This is an extract from a recent publication by the Data Analytics Working Group of the IAASB, Internal Auditing and Assurance Standards Board. They talk about exploring the growing use of technology in the audit with a focus on data analytics. And they talk about what is data analytics and what is the impact on audit quality. And they give you various areas where you can use data analytics. I suggest you download this publication. It gives you a very good insight on how data analytics could be used. Now let's look at the second objective, which is the 7 steps for using data analytics. Now, first step is to identify the objectives and deliverables. What is that you want to accomplish by using the data? Second, you identify the data and the platform in which the data is available. Third, understand the business process and the system which processes the particular data. Then you identify and document the controls and the criteria and the tests you want to perform. And then using data analytics software, you apply the relevant tools and techniques and you draw the inference and insights from the data. And based on this, you prepare outputs and reports. I'll show you a practical demo as we go on about all the 7 steps. Let's take an example of a financial statement assertion. Now, if you look at a financial statement assertion, these are the 7 criteria which you want to establish. Whether the data is complete, is it accurate, is it valid, is it properly authorized, is the segregation of duties as envisaged and laid down by the management followed. You want to look at compliances, whether all the applicable compliance have been complied within the required time frame, and whether the cutoff concept has been correctly applied, which means all the transactions which have been recorded during the year are for that particular period only, and there are no transactions beyond or prior to that particular accounting period or year. Now, the important thing to remember is, in the case of digital data, the controls are embedded inside information technology. This is where you need to use data analytics tool to be able to access, analyze, and evaluate this digital data. This is where, as auditors, we need to have the skill to be able to access, analyze, review, and evaluate this digital data as per the assignment objectives so that we can draw the inferences and provide insights to the management. Now let's look at the key functions of data analytics software. Data analytics software does not necessarily mean that you use an independent data analytics software. Even Excel could be used as a data analytics software. Even the business process applications have various data analytics features which you can use. But the limitation is, in these case of applications, for example, let's say Infosys has got a banking software called Finacle, or let's say Tally is an accounting software, or ERP, SAP is an ERP software. In all the software, there are querying and reporting features through which you can extract the data as required by you, and you can infer insights. But there is one significant limitation. These software were not designed from the audit perspective. Excel is definitely an excellent tool, but if you want to accomplish audit objectives, you want to perform specific audit tests based on specific audit criteria, you find it will be difficult to perform those particular tests, or it take a long time. Whereas a specific data analytics software is designed exclusively for performing data analytics. They have all the functions which are required for data analytics. When I demonstrate some specific functions, you'll see how simple and powerful the data analytics functions of a software are. Now, these are some of the top 20 data analytics features. you should be able to perform aging. You should be able to append multiple files and combine this as one file. You should be able to perform authentication check. For example, you have the sales file and you have the authorization file based on which you can verify whether all the transactions have been entered within the authorization limits. You can also do classification of the data, which is similar to the pivot table. You can compare two different files and come to analysis. You can identify duplicates. You can identify exceptions and outliers. You can extract specific information based on your requirements. You can perform a format check to check whether the data is in the required format. For example, let's say GSTN has got a particular format, or PAN or TAN has got a specific format. You can perform a format check to check whether the data follows the exact format. You can filter the data, you can identify gaps, identify changes. You can query specific data based on required parameters. For example, you'd like to look at all cash payments above 20,000 rupees. You can query and pick the data. You can perform sampling based on your requirements. You can verify and perform whether all the transactions are in a particular sequence. For example, let's say all the invoices are in a sequence. Are there any gaps? You can do sorting. You can perform stratify and summarize. I'll be giving you a demo of most of the functions a little later. This is just to show you that you could be performing this in Excel also. But what I want to show you is how easy and simple it is to perform using a data analytics software. Now let's quickly go to the demo of the selected functions of Softcat. Before that, I want to give you a quick overview of what Softcat is all about. In one sentence, if I have to summarize, Softcat stands for software for computer assisted audit techniques. It helps you to plan ahead with the right knowledge. It helps you to stay ahead with the relevant skills. It helps you to learn ahead using the technology tools. It helps you to leap ahead of your professional career. It helps you to keep ahead by applying the computer assisted audit tools and techniques as required. And this helps you to invest in your future so that you are relevant. And you can summarize it as the auditor's dream come true. Now, these are the 7 key benefits of using Softcat. You can definitely enhance your skills and tools. You can grow your professional team and esteem. You find quite often when you perform data analytics, the audit is also impressed because you're able to do much more productive work in much lesser time. You can gain recognition as a thought leader. You can increase the productivity of your time. You can accelerate your income earning capability because you're able to do the same work in much faster way and be much more effective. You can provide better assurance and add value, and you can develop, empower, reach and impact. And to summarize all this, Softcat or data analytics helps you to apply thought to technology. You have your domain knowledge and subject matter expertise. You can apply this to the technology on the data and infer insights and provide valuable insights to management. Now, this summarizes the complete discussion we had so far. How does Softcat help in data analytics or CXOs? You have the knowledge and the skills, and the software provides you the tools and techniques. Applying this on the data, you should be able to provide validation. What is Softcat? It's India's first CAT or data analytics software developed by auditors for auditors to audit in any IT environment for any type of assurance or compliance assignment. It's developed with the effort of more than 50 man years. It's been designed by practicing CAs and used by hundreds of CAs across India. It's a Windows desktop software, which has the right blend of simplicity, ease of use, simple learning curve, practical to apply, and powerful functionality. It has the look and feel of the spreadsheet software, but it has the power of the database. Now, there are 2 versions of the software available now. One is called as the Softcat Enterprise. The second is the Softcat Pro. Softcat, I'll give you a comparative analysis a little later. Now, this gives you a comparative analysis. Both of them are independent data analytics software, which are easy to use and simple to learn. They have a look and feel of MS Excel, but with the power of database. It has Access database. We have got one more higher version, which has got SQL database also. When you use the data analytics software, you identify the data which is required and import the data from any type of a data source. Now, in Softcat Enterprise, there are more than 230 functions, whereas in Softcat Pro, it's primarily designed for the auditors and audit teams. It has more than 120 functions which are relevant for the audit. And the important thing is both of them help you to perform complex analysis in a few clicks, and it also has got auto documentation. This gives you a comparative analysis of what you can do. If you look at the panels, these are the type of panels which are available in the software, and it gives you what are the primarily use or benefit of this type of software. Now, similarly, if you look at from the primary benefit, it gives you a key concept of what are the benefits of using the software. Who are the users of SoftCat? As I told you, this can be used by the auditors to find answers to audit questions. It can be used by the fraud investigators to identify possibilities of fraud and to identify the evidence. And it can also be used by management and CXOs to understand the data intelligence which is hidden inside the data, and then based on which they can take decisions. Now, these are 7 steps for using SoftCat for data analytics. First, you get the data ready for data analytics. Make copy of the files. You'll never work on a original data. You make copy of the files and perform analysis only on copy of the file. You perform harmonized sheets to get the data and headers in the right format for analysis. Now, in this case, MS Excel is not applicable. You'll always better that you open the file which is relevant for your audit. Document the field description related business processes. You delete the fields which are not required, import only the data which is required, and then you review the field formats and change it to the required format. For example, if you have a date field, please ensure that all the date related, that column has only date related data. And remember, SoftCat or any data analytics software can perform data analytics. It can provide information, but to derive insight from the information, the auditor has to bring his domain expertise. Now, this is a comparison of SoftCat and other CAT software. What can you do with SoftCat? You can transform your audit process by migrating from a single purpose spreadsheet software to a multi-dimensional data analytics software. And you can experience the amazing power of audit technology at work using SoftCat. And you can query and interrogate the data and extract insight from information as required. What is important to remember is that auditor is supposed to be a creative problem solver. And most of the problems can be solved if you're able to analyze data correctly and completely. And this is what is possible by using the right tools. And SoftCat is one of the tools. It can definitely enhance your productivity and save significant amount of time. What are the core functions of SoftCat? I'm just doing a quick walkthrough of the functions. So these are the panels which are available in the software: curate, profile, analyze, investigate, document, utilities, and tools. And these are some of the functions. I'll give you a demo quickly in a short time. You've got aging, analytical review, authenticate, classify, compare files. You can perform a dynamic query, exceptions, identify duplicates. You can identify gaps, join files, MIS. Like I said, there are more than 100 functions or 200 functions in SoftCat Enterprise. Depending on need, you can use the functions as required. I always say that the data analytics software functions are like a buffet in a 5-star hotel. You pick and choose what is required. It's not necessary. You should use all the functions. Depending on your need, you will use the specific functions as required. Now, this summarizes all the discussion we had so far. What would be the type of analytics you want to perform? You need to understand the business process controls. Based on that, you identify what are the specific information criteria you are evaluating. For example, let's say if you're doing a GST audit, you would like to evaluate whether the GST sales and the tax which has been computed, whether it's input tax or output tax, whether it's been computed and correctly filed. Same thing for, let's say, TDS. This information of the TDS or GST is available in a digital format. You should be able to access this data, analyze the data using the data analytics software, and then based on that, you come to inference and identify exceptions or irregularities. So what can you do with the data analytics software? You can do more in less time. So what is most important, which happens when you use the data analytics, you get a macro perspective or a big picture perspective. You can definitely future-proof your career by being relevant today and tomorrow, by becoming valuable, by adding value, by using data analytics software. So this completes the concepts I talked about as far as the data analytics is concerned. So let me close this presentation. And I would like to quickly take you through the software. Okay, now this is what the data analytics software looks like. Now, if you see here, as I said, it has look and feel of Excel, but the power of database. But there are a few exceptions. You cannot add the data or you cannot edit the data. Now, if you double click, it'll give you the file definitions. You can change the file definitions if required. Okay, now let me come back here. Now, if you see here, This is the company. In the company, I got the, let's say you call it the auditee, and under this, I got the audit. Under this, I got the different files. Now, if you see here, I've got the account runs. If you look at the account runs, these are the fields which are available. I would like to look at the field definitions. I'll get to know what are the field definitions. You got the account ID, amount, and it tells me what are the data type. And if there's short name used, it gives me the data short name. I can also have context sensitive help for each of the functions. Now let me get started with, let's say, curate data. The first thing I've said is you need to get the data ready for audit. Now we've got some sample data. For example, here, if you see, look at the column name itself, you know what is that you can do. Okay, remove non-alphabetic characters, remove non-numeric characters, remove non-alphanumeric characters. Like that, we are given different samples of data. In this case, I'm using sample data. I'll also show you how to import data and perform analysis. Okay, so let's go ahead. Now I want to look at, let's say, some of the features of the software. Like I said, if you look at the home menu, you've got import data. So this is where you import the data. These are the different types of files which you can import. It could be MS Excel, it could be Office 2013, Office 2010, or even Office 2003. It could be MS Access Family, or it could also be delimited file or HTML files. You can also import from the clipboard. Now you use the import data feature. You can also copy the data. You can go to any particular element of data, rows or columns. You can prioritize and decide which record you want to go to. You have the columns, hide column and hide columns. These are some of the features pertaining to the files. Okay, if you come home menu. Now if you come to the file, this is where you open a new auditee. You can open a new auditee. You can open the existing auditee. You can delete. You can go to a new audit, new or delete audit. You can save a file. So if you look at the structure, you got the auditee, below that you got the audit, and then you got the files. You can also, under the file, you can also have a child file. In some cases, it is not possible to perform the analysis on the original file. In that case, what you do is you make a copy of the file, this is called as a child file, and you can perform analysis on the child file. Let's go ahead. Now if you look at the curate functions, this is what I said. Now let me come to the curate data and quickly show you some of the functions you can perform. Now I got this particular data. I want to remove non-alphabetic characters in this. Okay, so what do I do here? Now I can use this function called non-alphabetic characters. Now it tells me what are this. Now it's already by default selected the first column. I say okay. Now you see it will remove the non-alphabetic character in that particular column. Okay, let me just quickly see this. We have this non-alphabetic characters. So I can select the particular position column. I say whether I want the result in the result form or in Excel. I'm selecting the remove non-alphabetic characters. I say I want it in Excel. And I give the file name. I decide the path where I'm going to keep the file name. I say, okay. Now you find this data will be curated and the copy of the file would be saved in Excel. Now this, as I said, you cannot perform in the original data. In this case, what I do is I have to make a copy of the file and perform this function. Now, if you see here in Excel, this particular file has been made. It looks like we have not got the result. I think we'll check it a little later. Okay, now this is where you can perform most of the curate functions, like we have leading spaces, trailing spaces. This is where you get the data ready for audit. You harmonize the data and get the data ready for audit. Now let's come to the format data. If you look at the format data, this is what I was talking about. We have the GSTN format, PAN format, PAN number, etc. Now I would like to identify the format and do a format check. This is where I can use this particular data and perform the format check. Now I've looked at the core, this is curate functions. I can perform various types of curate functions. I can also convert a particular column into lowercase, uppercase, title case, or a sentence case. I can also remove multiple spaces. Okay, now these are all the functions which are there in curate. Now let's come to profile. Now if you come to profile, you can get the top last X, which means in the sales data, I want to pick up the top, let's say top 10 or top 20 like that. I can pick up the data. Okay, similarly, I can also perform, let's say stratify numeric, date, character, aging, classify. I'll come to this a little later. Let's have a quick overview of this. Then I can perform analysis of the data, which means I can identify duplicates, I can identify uniques, I can identify and remove duplicates. I can do what is called a same, different. I can also find duplicates in the same row. I can identify gaps, identify numerics, identify format. This is what I was talking about. Identify format. Now I said GSTN. I said show the field length and show me the result. When I say identify exceptions and say okay. Now if you see quickly, we got the result here. If you see here, there are about 240 plus data. Now here, if you look at this, these are the fields. So you know GSTN has to be 14, 15. Now here you got all this data, which is 15. Now if you get 14, now this is where you are getting the exceptions. So you are able to identify all the exceptions by performing the format check. Let's do one more check based on this. I identify format. Just look at the simplicity, how you can perform. Now I want to do based on the PAN and I say field length. I say, okay. Now on this PAN related data, now if you see in the last column, it has given the field length. Now I want to sort this identify exceptions. I just do a single click. I can sort this data. Now you see, I can find out which are the things which are less than 10. So I know which are the ones which are less than 10 or more than 10. So if you look at this data, 249 elements of data, I want to find which of them are correct. I just give 10, which means 230 elements of data are correct. And there are about 16 elements of data which are incorrect. Now this could be done. I'm just giving you a small example. This could be done for hundreds of records. This is how you can do a format. Similarly, let's say I want to do for a TAN. I just go to format and I select the column TAN. Okay, and I say show field length and also say identify the exceptions. I can get the result in the result form or I can get it in Excel. Now, if you see here, it is identified. There are totally 19 exceptions. Now, because I said exceptions, it filters out, it picks the first data as the standard. Based on that, it filters out and picks up, removes all the things which are not required and shows these are the exceptions which are there. Okay, now this you can perform for, if you see you got the GSTN data, you want to do a quick format check. There may be thousands of records and you can do this in a few seconds. You can also identify the mandatory data. For example, let's say you got tally data, the debit and credit column should be there, the date should be there, or let's say you're paying employees, the ID should be there. Like that, you can also identify the mandatory data. You can also perform a sequence check. You can sort. Now, like I said, you can sort it in a single click here, or you can sort it ascending or descending in a single click. Okay, you can also filter based on specific criteria. This is what are the functions we got in analyze. Similarly, you got investigate. In investigate, you got the three panels, analysis, explore, 3D report stratify, and 3D reports. And then you have relate. This is where you can join two files. You can join and compute, compare, three-way matching, append, consolidate, cross-tab. And you have the sampling functions. Okay, this gives you a list of all the functions. You can perform sampling based on the selection, interval, numbers, or total count. You can perform sampling based on the profile of the summarized data, classified data, or aging data. You can also establish a particular criteria, numeric criteria, or statistics, outlier, duplicates. You can also stratify and find out the sampling. I'll perform some examples a little later. You can also perform analysis based on the result. You also have various types of utilities, columns. You can split the columns, combine the columns, extract specific columns from the data. You can also see charts and extracts. You can also rerun, this is what I said, whatever functions you performed, you can rerun or refresh the task which you performed. You can also split by based on the groups or the values. You can also validate the email ID. You also have documentation features where you got the audit table, audit log, command settings, etc. Now let me just show you quickly the features. Now if you look at this, this is a file which is available, which shows you the complete list of all the functions which are available. It gives you the tab, the panel, the functions. Okay, and it gives you the brief tooltip or description. Now this is available for customers. This is also available on the website. So if you want to have a quick look at what are the functions which are available, you can quickly know which is the panel, which is the menu, and where this function is available. For example, in Stratify, what are the types of stratification available? You can perform Stratify numeric data or date related data or character data, or you can also perform based on aging data. In identify duplicates, these are the five types of tests you can perform. Similarly, identify gaps, you got numbers, format, change sequence, sort and filter, analysis. These are different types of analysis you can perform. You explore the data, RSF, there's a relative size factor, maximum variance factor, Benford law, and you also have various types of functions, 3D reports. You can also relate. You also have selection based on sampling. There are about more than 20 types of sampling functions which are available. And you also got the utility. This is as for Softcat Pro is concerned. Now these are the Softcat enterprise functions. So now compared to this, as I said, there are more than 230 functions which are available in Softcat Enterprise. Okay, so this will give you a quick idea. In the software, you also have got tip of the day. For each of the functions, you have a clear description. The same information is available with basic examples. Okay, now let's close this. Now let me show you. Now let's spend the next maximum amount of time by actually you practically working on the demo of the software. Now I have provided you a quick overview of the software. Now I'm going to go to, let's say, first let me pick up the sales file, sales trans file. This is sales trans file. It'll take a little time. There are about 6,000 plus rows. We are planning to add a loading image here. Now, if you see here, now this gives you a quick synopsis of this file. You got the invoice date. You got the invoice number, name, sales, and user ID. Let me perform about 4 to 5 tests based on this quickly. First, I want to do a quick profiling of the data. I just click on statistics here. Now, when I click on statistics, just see here what happens. I'm getting a quick statistics of this. This is based on the date field. Now I know total number of records is 6,400. What are the population January, February, March, April, etc. All these I get at one shot. Okay. It also gives me what are the earliest date and what are the latest date. What are the record number of the earliest dates and what are the record number of the latest date. Okay. Which means I can also double click and drill down and go to the particular elements of data. So this is where you perform a quick profiling of the data to understand what is the type of data which is available at a macro level. Now, if you see, this is numeric related data. Now, this tells me total number of rows is 6,400. What are the average of positive records, number of negative records? If there are any negative records, you can quickly find out this at one glance. A record of the minimum value, which is the one which has got the maximum value, what are the net value, what are the absolute value, what are the range, everything you get at one glance. It also gives me the total summary of the data. Okay. Now, let's come to the character fields. This is where you get the character fields. Okay, similarly, you can also extract MIS. For example, I want MIS based on the sales. I just click on the sales field here. And I want based on the, let's say, date wise. Now, if you see here, weekday wise, it gives me the particular information. Similarly, I want date wise. I'll be able to get the information based on each of the days. Okay, now if I want month wise, I just click on month wise, it gives me the complete summary of the sales, average sales, max sales, minimum sales, count of the sales for each of the months. I can also get quarter wise sales. See, just see here, just a quick one click and you are able to get this particular data. Okay, so this is how you can get the statistics. Let me come back to the file. Okay, let me take you to the most interesting part, okay, which is challenging part of the audit. Now I've got this journal file. Now let me take this journal file. This is journal file. Now you got this, you imported this from, let's say they're using a in-house software and you imported the transactions of all the JVs. Okay, now you'd like to know in this particular JVs what they have passed, whether the debit and the credit are correct. Okay, now what you could do is you can just look at the statistics here. When you click on statistics, and look at the totals of the debit and credit, you should be able to know whether the total tallies or whether there's a difference. Now this computing the statistics. Now let me come back to the numeric fields. Now if you see here, now here there is an issue in this particular data. The total of the debit is 2,914,4,183. The total of the credit is 2,897,0,670. Now my next challenge is to find out which are the vouchers which have got this difference, which have contributed to this difference. How do you find this? I can also look at the set date related fields. Now let me come back to the numeric field. Let's come back to journal. And now let's do analysis. I'll show you how you can do it. You can just imagine if you have to do this in Excel, what will happen? Now I don't want this narration field. So I can also hide this field, which is not required. So I had this column, I have got this particular data. Now, if you quickly look at the data, let's understand how the data is. I got this concepts here, checker. Now these are the fields which are available. You got the debit, credit, checker, JV number, ledger name, maker, narration, and yes date. Now here, I got, now, how do I get this information? Let's say if I'm doing in a pivot table, I can actually do the pivot table and do the summary based on the JV number and total the debit and the credit. And then I'll be able to get a summary of all the total and the debit and credit. Then add one more column, debit minus credit. And then I apply filter, pick up which are where there are difference between debit and credit. and those are the accounts which have got differences. Now, which means I have to do multiple steps and it's going to take some amount of time. Now, let's see how we can do through the data analysis. I've got this function called classify. I pick up the JV number. I have summarized debit and credit. I don't want percentage. Now here, I'm not doing any grouping by, which means I want total as per the JV number. Now here, JV number is unique. Okay, if you see here, each of the JV number is unique. How do I know? Because I've already gone through that. So you do analysis, you do a data dictionary so that you can get an idea about what are the type of the characteristics of the data. Now I want to compare, and I want to compare from the results. I want to have some of the debit, some of the credit, and I want to find which are the ones which are not equal. Correct? Now get the logic clear. I have the JVs. As per the JVs, I want to sum the debit and sum the credit, and I want you to give me the exceptions. Oh, it means I did a few clicks. Now let's look at the result. I say okay. See, in a few seconds, I've got this six transactions, six JVs, where the debit and the credit doesn't tally. So I can do further analysis on this. I can double click. I can go to the particular JV voucher. In this case, I think there is a problem in the drill down. Generally, when you double click on this, it should take me to the exact voucher. Okay, so here I just save this as Excel, or I click on Excel. This will be saved an Excel file, and then I can do the analysis. Now I'm ready for doing the audit, check why this happened. And then based on that, I can decide my further tests. Okay, this is how I can do analysis. Now let's say same thing I would like to know. Party-wise, I would like to do the totaling. I go to classify. I want to do based on the ledger name, and I want the sum of the debit and the credit. Okay. Now here I want to know pickup transactions where compare from the result based on the party. So it means I want to find out the, no, I can do the, let's say not this one. Let's say I do the compute where I say the debit and the credit, which means debit minus credit. Okay, so what did you do? Based on the ledger name, I'm totaling, they're taking the debit and the credit. Let's see what happens. I add this. So there is a problem in this particular data because I am not able to perform this analysis correctly. Let's do this again. I pick up the ledger name. I have the debit and the credit. Okay, let me just do this step. Okay, I'm not doing any grouping by. I got the ledger. I want total of the debit and the credit. Simple. Let's take this. Now, if you see here, for each of the parties, I got the count of transactions which happened, what are the total of the debit, and what are the total of the credit. Now, let's say I want to sort it based on the credit transactions. Okay, now this was double click. I think I have to do a single click here. Now, if you do a single click here, now you see based on this particular transaction, I know this DMX India, I got 154 transactions and they contribute 23%. Now, if you look at this one, if you want to do a sampling, now if you see here, I pick up the ledgers. Based on the ledgers, I know 23% of the transactions, the value of the transactions are computed with this. You got salary, you got custom duty like that, you can get the complete list of all the expenses. Similarly, let's say I do sorting based on the credit. Now here I get Rainbow Logistics, which has contributed nearly 21%. Salary payable seems to contribute 18%. Like that, I'm able to get a complete list of all the transactions. Now I want to do further analysis, pick up all transactions which are beyond a particular amount. Let's say I want to pick up all transactions which are greater than, let's say 1 lakh. Now I find there are totally 37 transactions which are greater than 1 lakh. Let's say I give it a 10 lakh. I get which are the transactions which are greater than 10 lakh. This is what I said. I did a simple verification based on the debit and the credit. Now let me hide this column. Now I got this maker and checker. Now one of the things I want to find out is which are the transactions where the maker and checker are same. So what do I do? I want to find duplicates in the same row. So what is that I want to find? The maker and checker, that's all. Okay, now I say okay. Now this should be able to tell me which are the rows. Now if you see totally 54 rows are there where the maker and the checker are same. Which means I've gone through thousands of transactions and pick up the transactions where the maker and checker are the same. Now here, let's say I want to pick up all the transactions pertaining to debit or credit. I can analyze this and find out this particular transaction pertaining to salary, where the maker and checker, which means there's a significant amount of transaction, where two times the salary of May and July, it has been prepared by one person and he is also authorized that particular transactions. So I can do a detailed authentication check and check why this happened. Okay, so this just to show you this, how I can find out, you'll see we're able to perform very powerful analytics in a few seconds. Now let me pick up one more example. I've got this voucher file. Now, if you look at this voucher file, these are also collection of transactions. Okay, now I've got this collection of transactions. Now I want to look at the statistics. I'm going to take another 15 minutes because I want to show you another 10 to 12 important functions. I just click on statistics. Now look at the statistics. Sum of all records. You remember last time you said 151,895. So it looks like the values are correct. But still, I'd like to verify whether each of the transactions for each of the voucher types, the debit and the credit tally. Okay, overall, although the tally, I would like to verify individually whether these particular transactions for each of the vouchers tally. For that, you need to understand what is the type of data which is available. Now here, let's understand, last time we had a unique JV. Now in this case, if you see the voucher numbers which are there, you got different types of voucher types. Okay, for each of them, they're starting with a unique, for each voucher type, they're starting with the same voucher number. So it means I cannot do based on the voucher number. So it means I need to do take up both the parameters, which is voucher type and the voucher number. How do I do this? I can come to profile. I can do the same thing, classify, or let me pick up the group by. I do group by. What is that I want to group by? Group by voucher type. Okay, select classify. In this case, I want the debit and the credit. Now I have got group by and I want the voucher number, which means there are actually two elements. First, actually do group by based on the voucher type and then based on the voucher number and then total the debit and the credit. Okay, I'm not doing any competition. I'm just doing this analysis. If I do this, I can also do a comparison here. If I do a comparison from the results, I have the sum of debit, the sum of credit, and I want to find out not equal to. Okay, now just see this. Here I've done doing competition based on thousands of transactions, and in a few seconds I've got this result. Now what do I get here? Now if you see here, although the debit and credit tallied internally, now if you see here voucher number, journal voucher number 4, 364, internally there is a difference because between the number of decimals there is some difference. Okay, so let's ignore this 364, 375, 318, 865, 1292. It means it could be 1292.14. In the second element, it might have been stored in Excel as 1292.145. Now here, if you look at this one, 1689026, 1689206. Here, if you see, there is actually a difference. In the sales voucher, the debit is 26,000, where the credit is 25,000. Now here, you see here again, sales voucher number 4, 231,300. And here it's 232,300. Here again, if you see sales voucher number 377,476, here I got 375,476, which means I'm able to find out the difference in thousands of vouchers. I'm able to isolate and pick up the differences which are there. Now, this is what I said is the power of the data analytics software. Now let's come to some important functions. Let's say I go to procurement file. This is a procurement file I've got. What I would like to do is, I'd like to investigate this data, and for the procurement, my audit test is, I want to find out in this procurement. Now, if you just do a double click, you'll get the file definition. I got the material code, I've got the unit price, I've got the quantity. Now, my audit test, one of the audit tests is, for each of the material code, unique material code which has been purchased, or the material which has been purchased, I want to find unit price. And for the unit price, I want to apply what is called as a relative size factor. So I select the material code and I select the unit price and I find out the relative size factor. Okay. Now let's look at the result and understand what is the inference you can draw from this. There are about 1,400 plus records here. Now here, based on this data, if you see here, relative size factor analyzes the data based on the first maximum unit price and the second maximum price, the difference between the two, and it applies the percentage. Now, if you see here, D86031, it was bought 94 times. The maximum price at which it was bought was 5124. The lowest, second highest is 151. And there's a big variance of 34 times. We definitely know there should be some issue here. When I double click, you should be able to give me the complete list of the transaction. This is what I called as the drill down. Now, if you see here, now based on this particular thing, I find, now when you do a further analysis, this is what I said, you bring your domain expertise. Now, if you look at the material name, the material code is same, whereas you look at the material name is different. So it means it's actually monitors, which has been wrongly coded as monitors which have been wrongly coded as monitor cover by giving the wrong code. Now, if you see the price for the monitor covers also, it has been bought at 151, and there are monitor covers which have been bought at 51 rupees, and there are monitor covers which have been bought at 31 rupees. So this gives you a complete analysis for each of these particular products at what price they have been bought. Based on this, you can find, you hear here you see that the general price seems to be 31, but there are a few exceptions. Now you can quickly find out the exceptions and do analysis to check why these expense variances have occurred. Now let's say the person who is doing the analysis. Now here also you look at the second type of data. Here you got 700 and it is 70. Now here it's 7 times. Now this is 133 and 31. This is how you are able to find out inference from insights by a few clicks. Now in this case, which means we are able to audit all the procurement data, and based on each of the material code, we are able to find out the exceptions. Now, this is based on the relative size factor. Now, let's say the accountant or the person who's committing this irregularity is already aware of the relative size factor. In that case, he may buy, let's say the item costs 115, he may buy it at 1,550, and the second item, he may buy it at 1,500. So in the relative size factor, it may not be found. Okay, this is where we apply what is called as the maximum variance factor. What you do, you select the material code and then you select the unit price. This is what I said, you know what you want. It becomes very, very simple to find out. Just one click. Now I should be able to get the complete inference from this. Now, if you see here, there are totally 13 items. Now, if you see the same item here, 5124, my lowest price 31, 700. Earlier we got, if you see the difference, now we are getting 31, 555 and 331. Like that, I'll be able to find out between the maximum and the minimum, what are the variance and what are the number of times the percentage variance is there. So it means out of all the purchases which have been made, I've been able to pick up all the exceptions in a few seconds. Now just imagine what is the power of the audit when you're able to do analysis like this. Now let's say we want to do a Benford law on this. So I do the Benford law based on the amount, which means now I'll show the result and explain to you the Benford law. Just look at the simplicity. I just decided to do Benford law. I know what is the field on which I need to apply. Benford law has to be applied on a random population of data, which is not sequenced. For example, I cannot apply it in an invoice number. I click generate. Now I got the Benford law. If you see here, the possibility as per Benford law is the possibility that digits start with 1 should be 13%. The possibility the data will start with digit 2 is 18%. The possibility it start with digit 9 is 5%. Okay. And then it computes the actual percentage and gives you the variance. And it also gives the difference in the occurrence. Now, based on this, what can you find out? You can find out if somebody has inserted data based on certain irregularities. For example, let's say the limit is 10,000. Now there are people who are passing entries for 9,000 rupees or 9,500 or 8,500. In that case, what will happen? As per the Benford law, the number of occurrence percentage should be only 5%. Whereas as per the actual data, you find there's a big variation. And then you can do further analysis based on this. This is how Benford law is used mostly in case of forensic audit or fraud investigation to identify where patterns of fraud have occurred. Now let's come back again here. Now I was talking about invoices. Now let's do a comparison. I got this invoices 2019 data. I'm just showing you some of the powerful functions, and I have got the invoices 2020 data. Now I want to do a comparison between these two types of data, which means I want to compare the sales which happened for 2020 and 2019. It gives me the number of invoices here. Now, what is that function I want to use? Now, here I want to use a function called compare. I go to compare. Now, invoice 2020 is the base. I'm going to pick up invoice 2019. Now, what is the field on which I want to compare? I want to compare based on the customer number. And I want to pick up the amount, which means based on the amount I want to pick up. Not only that, I want to find out the difference between the amounts. I say compute the amount, the difference. Okay, I can also do the group by, which means group by salesman. I can also do that. As of now, I'm not doing that. I say okay. Now I see there are 5,000 items of sales in both the years, and I'm doing a customer wise analysis. In a few seconds, I got the result here. Now, if you see the result here, what do I get? For each of the customer number, I get to know what are the sales in the current year, what are the count of the sales of the last year, and what is the difference? Similarly, the difference in the total amount. Okay. Now, if you see here, I want to pick up which are the transactions, customers who are new. If I just say zero, it means customers who bought only last year, who didn't buy this year, who didn't buy last year. These are the customers. Now, similarly, if I go to this here, second 2019, if I go here and give zero, it means these are the customers who were there last year, who didn't buy anything last year, who bought this year. Okay, this is how I can do the analysis. Now I want to do a quick summary and find out where the customers, where we got the maximum deduction. I can do analysis like this. I can also find out based on a particular percentage. Now this is how we can do a comparative analysis of two types of data. Can I do consolidation? For example, I have got this April data, and I got April, May and June data. Now I want to do consolidation. I got consolidation. Now I say I've already got April. Now I want to do expense of May and June, and I want to do summarize based on the expenditure, and I want based on the head. Okay, which means now I'm doing the consolidation based on the expenditure. Now see, in a quick, this one, we already got this one. It gives me the complete list of all the expenditure for each of the head along with the count and the sum. This is how we can do the consolidation. We can also join and compute. For example, I got trial balance of 2 years. I can join and compute whether the difference of the last year, the opening balance, the closing balance of last year matches with the opening balance of this year, and what are the differences. Now let's show you some quickly a few analysis functions. Now see, this gives you a quick overview of all these functions which you said. You can do a dynamic query also. You can also append data based on specific things which you want. Let me show you some sampling. Now I can do sampling. Let me do sampling based on summarized. Now let me go to the right type of data. Let me pick up sampling based on the sales with items. My objective is, in the sales which have happened, there are about 6,400 transactions. I want to pick up sampling based on some specific criteria based on the value. Okay, so I pick up summarized. Now if you see here, I'm going to summarize based on the, I can pick up this based on sales amount or the unit sold. Okay, accumulate on the sales amount. That's all. Now if I say okay, now this should give me group the items as per each unique value of sales. Okay, and how many number of times this transaction has occurred. So it tells me there are totally 35 unique type of transactions which occurred during the year, and it gives me the complete listing. Now based on this, I want to do the sampling. I can also sort it in ascending or descending order. Now I want to apply sampling. I just say enter sample. I just give the number. For example, in this case, let's say I give 4 samples. Here I get 3 samples. I can decide what are the number of samples. And then I say extract. Based on the criteria you applied, it's going to extract that number of samples. In this case, it's going to be 10 samples. Based on the value you have given, it's able to extract the samples. Okay, I've done classify based on the sampling based on this. Okay, let's say I want to do sampling based on the outliers. What is this outlier? Let's look at this. Now outliers, I want to pick up based on the sales amount. Okay, now what is group by? Which means I want to find out based on the name of the dealer. Okay, and I want to find out what are the sales more than 3 times. Okay, which means I want to find out items which have been made sales to a dealer wise, which is 3 times the average. Which are the items which are more than 3 times the average sales? Now, if you see here, I can get for each of the dealers, I get to know what are the number of transactions happened. There are 3 times the exceptions are there. These are the high value transactions which have been done. I can do further analysis based on the, I can want to select the sample. In this, I want to select the sample. Let's say I'm going to pick all the 3. Here also I'm going to pick all the 3. And I say extract. Okay, so it means now here, okay, sorry. The count is actually 1. That's where I think we got the problem. I should have given enter size. The count is actually 1. I should have given maximum of 1. Okay, it's actually extracted the count of 1. So it means this is the number of transactions where it is exceeded. This is how I can extract the outliers. Now I'll just show you a few more things. Let's say I come to the sales trends file. Now I want to find out the duplicates. Now based on the invoice number, I want to identify the duplicates. I come to the analysis. Now I've got duplicates. Now here I want to find out duplicates based on the invoice number. Okay, now I'm going to say in duplicates. I say I can also do extract exact duplicates, which means I can go for each of the items, which of them exactly match, which means same transaction entered twice. If I select this, it will pick the duplicate based on this. I can get duplicate based on the details or the summary. I selected the details. So in this case, it should be able to give me, for example, here, if you see here, 1005, how many times it has occurred? It has come twice. 1280 is occurred twice. It also tells me which is the invoice number and what are the details of transaction, when did it occur, who has passed the transaction. This is what is called as identify duplicates. Now let's say I come to the payroll file. I come to this payroll file. Or in this payroll file, I would like to find out this, what is the salary which has been paid to each of the employees. What function can I use? I can do a classify. And I say based on the employee number, and I want the total of the amount actual payment made for the percentage. Based on this, I say okay. Now this should be able to give me what the total salary paid, and right in the beginning I get an exception. This employee 1001 has been paid 13 times. Okay, so I can just do a drill down and check why this person has been paid 13 times. Is there a payable entry which is passed? What has happened to this particular transaction? Now if you see here 1001, it gives me the list of entries which have been the sales, which now this I think we got it mixed up. So I should have been able to pick up this particular transactions. I think there's some problem in the query. Yeah, it is picked up based on the dealer. I think it's giving the wrong data. Okay, so I should be able to drill down and pick this information. I just do a quick review, and then they find this particular employee has been paid only once, and he doesn't have employee number. This employee 1035 has been paid only once. He doesn't have an employee number, and this gives me the amount. So look at this. Based on this, I can find out the exceptions and I can find out the irregularities. Now let me show you one last function. Let's say I've got this procurement file. Okay, now what is that I want to perform in this case? I want to find out what is called as same, same, different, which means now in this case, the vendor material code is same, but the unit price is different. Okay, it's very simple. So I want to based on the summary. Now, if you see here, you remember we did the RSF earlier. Now here we are able to get, now AA0365, if you see here, this been bought at 76 times at 31 rupees. Again, five times have been bought at 55 rupees. 155 has been bought one times, and 555, it has been bought one time. So it means I'm able to quickly get a complete analysis of the procurement, and I'm able to find out the exceptions. Now just see the power of the analysis we can perform. This is just some examples of what I showed you is possible through data analytics. We can also relate two files and find out the exceptions. I can join two files, and based on that, I can find out, for example, the authorization limit is exceeded like that. I just gave you a quick idea of how you can perform various types of analysis. Now, like I told you, there are more than 100 types of functions. Okay, I forgot one important thing. Let me just show you quickly in 1 minute, and then I think we are ready to close. I got this Excel file. I want to show you how do you get the data into this particular file. I got this one, two, three. These are three Excel worksheets which are there. Okay, I'm going to close this. Okay, and I'm going to show you how to import this. How do I get started? How do you get the data into the data analytics software? Now in this case, I'm coming to file. I say new. Let's say I call it as a webinar demo. I'm giving the name of the assignment. Okay, I'll say okay. It is created. Now it gives me the name. Let's call it as test one. Okay, I say okay. I can also give the other details. Now it has got this particular data. Now it gives me the file. Okay, this is an Excel. These are different types of files. I say next, browse files for import. I've kept this sample file, webinar docs for demo. This is sample data. I say open. Now this is how it opens the three worksheet files. I say next. It gives me all the fields which are available in this particular files. Let's say I don't want to import certain fields. Let's say I don't want the narration. Here also I look at a few other things which I don't require. I can decide which are the fields which I want to import, which means in Excel file, you may have so many data. You can decide which are the fields. Now here also I don't want narration. Okay, I don't want transaction type. Then I say next. Now you see, it gives me the complete list of the files. Now just see the magic it happens. This is how you get the data into SoftCat. Now it's importing the data. See 6066 has been imported. This 1349 and 1327, all these have been imported. I said done. Now you see this data has already come into, this is how you get the data into the data analytics software. Now I showed you an example through Excel. These worksheet files which are there, I've already got the data. Now this is the daybook file. I've already got this daybook file. Okay. Now I got this aging two fields. I want to perform some analysis on this. I can perform the analysis. So I can, once I got the data, I can perform any type of analysis based on this particular data. Let's say I got this aging two field. I want to do stratification of aging. I got the receipt date. Okay, I got the sale date. Okay, now it finds the difference between the two. Now let's say I want to give as 12, a difference, and I say fill. Okay, and I say okay. Now this should be able to compute the difference between the receipt date and sale date and do a quick certification as to who are the parties who have been paying and what is the normal payment schedule. Now you see 25 to 36, 3083 people have paid. So if you look at the percentage count, so you'll be able to get an idea who are the defaulters. Okay, how many defaulters are there? So just imagine being able to provide insights to the management based on this. You're able to pick up who are the parties who are late payers, and based on the number of days, you're able to find out all the transactions. Okay, so this is how you get the data into the data analytics software. Once I get the data, first I do is I perform a profiling, which means I look at the statistics. The statistics will give me insights of this particular data. I can perform MIS, date field characteristics, etc. And then I'm ready to do analysis based on what I want to perform. Okay, I hope this presentation is useful. My idea was to give you a quick clarity on the power of the data analytics software. Okay, I'll stop sharing. If you got any questions, you can ask. I hope the presentation is useful. You can ask in the chat window or you can unmute and ask the questions. Okay, so this webinar is being recorded. We'll also make a presentation, a copy of this recording available to you. You can visit our website to look at the webinar recording. So if you want to walk through the webinar once again, I think you'll be able to go through the webinar and get an idea of the specific functions. I plan to do a series of webinars covering different functions. You can watch our website. Generally, we do it in the first week of the month. Thank you very much and see you again in the near future. Bye. And thanks for attending.